Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to study an important application of laser, and that is a hologram. A hologram is basically a 3D image. So what do you mean by a 3D image? So first of all, for that, let us understand what do you mean by a 2D image. A photograph is basically a 2D image, wherein it only gives us the distribution of the intensity of light. In contrast, a hologram is called as a 3D image because it captures not only the intensity, but also the phase of a particular object. So what is the first step? In hologram, the first step is nothing but the recording of the hologram. For the recording of the hologram, we require a very high intensity, coherent and monochromatic source of light. And what can be a better source than lasers? So we use a laser that is very broad, and we split this laser into two rays. One of the rays is the reference beam, and the second ray is actually called as the object beam. So the reference beam is made to fall on a mirror, whereas the object beam is actually made to fall on the object. So the reflected beam from the mirror, which is basically the reference beam, will actually be incident on a photographic plate, and simultaneously the object wave will also be incident on the same photographic plate. So when we are having these two waves, one is the object wave and the second is the reference wave, both these waves will actually interfere. But when they are interfering, they will actually capture the phase of the object, and this phase and the intensity will actually be recorded as the intensity pattern on the photographic plate. This is how we record a hologram. In the second part, we deal with how to read this hologram. Second part of holography is nothing but the reconstruction. So for the reconstruction of the hologram, we actually use the same wavelength of light that was actually used for the recording purpose. By light, I mean over here the laser light. And when this particular light actually falls on the hologram behaves as a diffraction grating. And since it behaves like a diffraction grating, it gives you two types of images. One type of image is nothing but the real image, which is actually forming at the first order diffraction maxima. And the second type of image is nothing but the virtual image, which is formed behind the hologram. Now, this is basically a 3D image, and you can view it from all angles, and it is this that gives you a 3D view of the entire hologram, a 3D perspective of the entire hologram of the object which has been recorded. Sincere thanks, students, for watching this particular video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and do subscribe to Ikeda. Thanks a lot.